So anyway, it turns out what I've done is just put isolate on. Happens, so I wouldn't worry about it. Anyway, what I need to do now is have a look at my armor. And I think what I'm going to do is if we go into this piece. And I need to go around this and just basically select lock pieces, so that's these. Right, so what I'm going to do now is extrude them. Then I'm going to grab the edges. So there. Turn extrude off while I'm doing this. There. There. Now I've got to do these one at a time. I can't obviously do it on both sides or it'll look very, very silly. I'll just bring those in. Again here. If you're not comfortable working by eye, then you know, practice. I'm not going to tell you to do something else. It's practice, okay? It's a very useful thing to be able to do. Okay, I'm going to isolate this selection for a moment. And take these bits over here. It's like my old friend Wayne Robson's online. Okay, and the bottom one. And just do a bevel. And then that one. Okay, so that gives us this sturdy looking shape here. Like that. Now, got some chamfers to do really. I don't have to worry about any so much over there, but I do have to worry about them over here. So I'm going to start going through my model, selecting edges where I think I need them. Take your time. If like me you're a little bit tired, definitely take your time. Trust me, you will bollocks this up if you do not. And here. Okay, now here. See, so we've got all these shapes and this one here. A bit separated by area, so I have to go in and do these bits as well. Okay, so that's the first part done. Nearly, just go around. Get all these little chums here that you think you'd need as well. I'm going to just use select tool rather than select and move. And when you think to yourself, is it worth doing this? Yes. I've never been told off by Pete Draper for not doing proper chamfers. I can arrange him to tell you off. Well, not told off, gently reminded and then given a smack. It's an artist thing, you don't understand. Okay, so this part is proper now. Just check the inside angle there. So now if I use my chamfer tool, don't need a big chamfer, tick. Okay, and that will maintain our machine-like edges on this. Now then, for these ones, this is easy, let's go straight through the middle there, just do another chamfer. And then over this edge. See, once these are done, the good thing is that, I mean, I was going to do the hips before I did the armor, but then I thought, well, if you do that, I'll give you like 4 seconds to work out what the problem is with that one. Two. worked it out yet? Okay, well, if we position the armor first, we can't build the armor on top of the leg that's in a pose. So if I build the hips, which, you know, are obviously going to be quite a big and important piece, it's going to be quite easy to get them and your model all posed up. But then when it's time to stick the armor on it, it's going to be really problematic. So that is why we build these first. We can, you know, do other things at other times, but this needs to be done now. I'm just going to do my edges here. Let's go around it all. Do not press Control A. Okay, keep your finger well away from that goddamn button. It's such an accident waiting to happen. And you'll regret it. You'll be like, oh man, why didn't I listen to Chris? He's always right. I should send him extra money. And here. Remember, anything that's like even remotely resembling a sharp edge, you want a chamfer. That's a chamfer. It's not a padlock. Okay, it's a padlock. It's a padlock. Always loved that episode of Simpsons. Truancy, that's a padlock. Okay, and now I'm going to take the chamfer button. Chamfer. And whilst the chamfer is on, that look around my model and see any really grave issues I've created and not fixed. Oh look, there was one, you see? Kalik. Going around it. Don't be afraid. Just, you know, make it yell teedy. Straight edge, it should be a chamfered edge. It's not a chamfered edge, it's not a happy edge. It's not a happy edge, I'm not a happy Chris. There we go. You can see there's a few here that we missed. You can kind of tidy them up. A bit, not too much. The problem is that with a chamfer, if you miss it, you're basically missing the boat. Yeah, you kind of did not get on board. Now, these are very minor chamfers. And as they're internal parts, they might not even be noticed. But we're going to bloody well do them anyway. If I did miss, and the good thing is that apart from you, no one else will know our guilty secret. No one. Okay, come in here. Now down here. See how easy it is to miss pieces? Just do them all, alright? Now, the inside here, that needs doing. This part needs doing. Okay, I think we've got somewhere. So I can just click OK. Tick, done. Now, I come over here and end my isolation. And suddenly our leg is taking on a way more brutal looking aspect. Plus, it's now attached in to this, which is a help, on this thing here. Now, if I isolate this selection again, and I want to go through this edge here, do a connect. I want to do two connects actually. Tick, tick. You'll be like, Chris, why you be doing that? And I'm like, well, watch. Now, look at these edges. One there. Now then, this one is an edge that I have to get into just there. Get it lined up, you know. Let's have a look. Don't want to ruin my model. Now then, if you're having trouble selecting things, let me show you a cunning thing. Do that. And hide unselected. Oh look, suddenly things are easy again. Don't know if you knew you could do that or not, but now you do. And it's a very useful little tool. There we go. Now if I go back to polygon mode again. And unhide all. The polygons come back. Yay! See, and now we've got these nice shapes here as well. Okay, end isolate. There. See? Easy peasy lemon squish squash. Now, the last bit is, let's choose ourselves a nice rivet. Because you need to do with a rivet. So, what have we got? And this is just going to be placed on a rivet. I'm not going to embed this into the geometry. Now, we've got that one. Ooh, we've got that one, which is quite a nice little one, or that one, which isn't. Okay, I like that one. So, let's go to my object paint, and my list, and add selected. There we go. Now, over here, and hide unselected. Okay, and this will allow me to paint onto these. I do apologise again about my squeaky, squeaky thing. So let's start down here and paint on, let's see, paint on selected objects, which will be this, this, and this, with those. Okay, so, and I'm going to paint from my list. Second, unhide all just in case. Yeah, okay, so unhide all. So now I can go straight into painting detail bolts straight onto this. First things first, let's change the scale on these. Is that a bit big? Let's go around it and we want to be logical about where we place our bolts. It's important to make sure there's enough space. Don't put them here because it looks like eyes and a nose. Just notice that one. And don't be afraid to not have too many bolts. Okay, it's better to have fewer than too many. Right, now down here. Also, symmetry, yeah, it's a good thing, but think about all the repairs. You know, if you ever had an old motorcycle, you know for a fact that, you know, you've got a surfeit of bolts knocking around. So, don't worry about having, you know, a slightly odd amount of bolts on one side compared to the other. All these are doing is drawing your eye. That's their job. If they're doing that, then they're doing it correctly. There we go. And then maybe one just here. Offset slightly to one side. Nice. Now over here. Really just go to town. Bolts give the model a lot more the appearance of strength. Don't need them there. can even have them in the middle of this if you want. So if you are, take a moment or two just to line up. There we go. That works for me. And now I can close down, turn off my select tool, and instead go to my attach tool. And be careful here. Press F4 so you can see what you're attaching. Before you attach, if you're not 100% sure that it's working in the position you've chosen for it, delete it rather than attaching it. Okay, so that one's done. And with the bolts, it looks a lot better because the smooth shape's now been broken up. This one. Good thing is that when we've got F4 hit, you can kind of see where some of the problem areas might be and clean them up as you go along. We've got plenty of lovely room for wires and things. Okay, that one looks good. Let's go down here and unmove it. If you think it's moved, it probably has. And it's better to have to redo the last action by mistake than have to fix the model further down the line. So Control-Z if you're not sure. If something else moves, like the piece you just did, then obviously you didn't move your model. Just redo the last action. Cannot be too careful when you're doing modelling. Right, hit F4. That ain't bad. Okay, so now it's a case of attaching these to the correct parts. Now then, the part here, that's responsible for that bit. So, I think you definitely need to be attached to that bit. You need to be attached to that bit. So that when this moves, everything moves. Now I'm noticing that those buggers there aren't attached either. Thought I'd attached them, that's okay. Now those are attached too. And at the top here, do not want to attach all those together. See, made a mistake, Control-Z. Grab this one, and done. Okay, so that armors up the front of our leg rather nicely, I think. And will lead us nicely as well into the next part. So, until then, adieu, adieu. Oh, and you. Ooh, what a lovely stretch. Till then, TT, bye-bye.